Sunday Brunch on WDVR 89.7 FM. And we're talking today with Mike Farraher, the author of This Is Your Brain on Shamrocks and the brand new This Is Your Brain on Shamrocks 2, 50 Shades of Green. Welcome, Mike.
Thank you. Top of the morning to you and all your listeners.
And top of the morning
to you. It's a great season to be green.
Indeed. Let's get straight to the book. The title of your books is This Is Your Brain on Shamrocks, and that's for the benefit of anyone under, let's say, 40. It's a reference to an old public service announcement.
That's right.
You remember this?
I do remember that indeed. Yes.
Well, it was an egg, right?
Yeah.
So that was your brain, and then the egg was cracked and fried, and that was your brain on drugs. The message being, drugs mess up your brain. So, Mike Farraher, tell us, how do shamrocks mess up one's brain?
Well, shamrocks would mess up one's brain because it's that inbred Irish Catholic guilt that you usually get from your mother or your father. So here's an example. Let's say you're on the back deck and the last mass has come and gone and you didn't go to it. So that little voice inside your head might say something like, well, you know, I'm sure the Lord Jesus Christ didn't want to get up the day he died for your sins. That's your brain on shamrocks. It's always that little voice that we all have inside our heads. If you're an American Irish, you typically will have that voice that's inside your head, sound like your mom's, has a brogue, and is really just guiding every thought, word, and deed that you have.
Mm-hmm. And so what was the direct inspiration? What made you say, I think I'll write a book about this?
It actually wasn't a book. Mm. It was a series of essays. I'm the music writer for the Irish Voice, and I have a whole page column, and sometimes when the weeks were slow in terms of music or music news, I would ask my editor, you know, would you mind if I started to write these little essays about my life? These are things I would have told at the bar, that would have gotten a laugh. And she said, sure. So we tried one or two of them, and just the response that we got from the readers was just overwhelmingly positive. And you know, you'd get these Facebook posts and you'd get these emails that would say, oh my God, you're writing about my life, I had the same mother. Even people that, you know, were half Irish, half Polish that would have read the paper, they said my Polish mother would do that as well. So, you know, it really was universal and beyond Irish. I think a lot of people that grew up, you know, with a Western European upbringing, probably had that very, very same upbringing, the Italian, Polish, Irish guilt, you know. So it has a fairly universal theme as well.